Traditionally, in India, we used to collect milk from milk vendor, make yogurt at home, and from yogurt, we used to churn and make butter. With that butter, we make ghee. In Europe, in Germany, if you go to any supermarket, you see a lot of varieties of butter that is available in the butter section. Sometimes you wonder which butter to choose from a lot of options available from supermarket. There are sweet cream butter, sour cream butter, salted butter, unsalted butter, garlic butter, herbal butter, spreadable butter, and many more varieties. For making Indian ghee, selecting the right butter is very important. Spreadable butter will have a soft consistency, so even if you store it in the fridge, you can take it out easily and then apply it on your bread and then have it. So this is not the right option for making ghee because normally they add some vegetable oil to it, like canola oil, to keep the solid texture to a little bit softer so that you can easily take it and apply it on the bread. For ghee, you should not use salted butter, so let's leave that option too. You should not use any flavored butter in ghee making, so let's leave the garlic butter and also the herbal butter and any other flavored varieties of butter. And finally, now we are left with two options: sweet cream butter and sour cream butter. Sweet cream butter is made from collecting the cream from top of milk and then churning into butter. Sour cream butter is made from collecting cream from milk and allowing this cream for fermentation by adding some culture. So once the cream is fermented and the butter is churned from the sour cream, also the taste of the butter will be slightly sour in sour cream butter. Two options, sour cream and sweet cream butter. But there are a lot of brands available in sweet cream and sour cream butter. So today I have collected some varieties of butter to show you which butter is good for making Indian ghee. So here I have Landleby butter, Kerrygold and Milbona butter. All these three are from sour cream varieties. Meagle Finer is sweet cream butter, and Meagle is also having another which is called yogurt butter. Traditionally in India we make ghee from yogurt, so this is more or less similar to Indian variety of butter. Let's talk about the fat content that is present in the butter. So all of these butters are having 82% of fat, and this yogurt Meagle butter is having 65% of fat. So the amount of fat that is present in the butter determines the amount of ghee. All these butters will give more quantity of ghee. Yogurt Meagle will give less quantity of ghee because it contains more milk solids and water content. Let's talk about the quantity of ghee that is made from these butters. So all these butters are 82% of fat. Making ghee, you will get 200 grams of ghee. Yogurt Meagle butter will produce around approximately 150 to 160 grams of ghee because it's having less fat content. Let's talk about the taste of the butter and ghee. Sour cream butter will have a slight tanginess in butter. Sweet cream butter will have a cream and mild taste. But after making ghee, all of the ghees will taste the same. There won't be any tanginess because the milk solids will get separated while making ghee and it will be discarded. Let's go to kitchen and make ghee from all of these five varieties and discuss about different factors between them. Butter is added to the pan and I started cooking on a medium flame. Yogurt butter from Meagle had a long cooking time because of the water content and the lot of milk solids that is present. This butter, the ghee is ready when you see the browning at the bottom of the pan. Meagle Finer butter had a lot of foams forming while cooking and during the cooking, so you might need to consider a larger pan. And this is a sweet cream variety of the testing that we are doing today. The ghee is ready. Allow them to cool down and strain out the milk solids and store the ghee in a glass container. To compare the color of ghee, all the ghee had a beautiful yellow color. Kerrygold had a light, vibrant yellow color. By the flavor, All the ghee had a beautiful, wonderful aroma, but yogurt meagle butter and Lanlibe had a slightly more flavor. To compare the texture of ghee, all the ghee had a beautiful grainy texture. Regarding the state of ghee, when it is in cool form, it has to be solid state. If there is some liquid floating on top, this is fine too. Normally, when the ghee is heated on the pan, it will turn into liquid. So it is completely fine. If I have to compare the ghee that is made from all of these butters, they had a very negligible amount of difference. All of them had a good color, flavor, texture, taste. So if you are using any of these varieties, you can go ahead and use it. If you are interested to know which butter I am using for making ghee, I am using Lanlibe for 15 years. Lanlibe is having a very good flavor, texture, color and also taste. So I am very happy about using Lanlibe. This is my personal choice. And Lanlibe is not paying me anything for this video. Thanks for watching the video and please let me know which butter that you are using for making Indian ghee. I hope this video was useful in choosing the right butter for making Indian ghee. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe and also click the bell icon for notification. Until next time, bye-bye.